At last you've arrived. Good, good. There is much to do and every moment is critical. I'm Overseer Tremel. For decades I've administered the trials that prove who is and is not worthy to join the Sith Order. The trials are a chance to weed out the weak. Those who face them either survive and become Sith, or die.
Mark my words, I am destined to be Sith.
It wasn't destiny that brought you here. Yes, you are here and ahead of schedule because of me. I expect you to obey. You face your trials, you serve me, and I will make you the most powerful acolyte here.
Sounds like a plan.
The trials themselves are difficult enough, but they are hardly the greatest threat you face. There's an acolyte here named Vemrin. He's your enemy, and he will try to kill you. We must prepare you.
Let him try. I'll destroy him.
With my guidance, someday you'll destroy all your enemies. That practice sword you've arrived with is insufficient. The blade of lesser acolytes. You need a dominating weapon. In the tomb of Ajunta Paul, there's an old armory. A strong Sith warblade awaits you there. The tomb is thick with claw slugs. Deadly, savage creatures. Be speedy, but careful. They've been the end of many an acolyte.
Just tell me where to go.
Once you acquire the warblade, I suggest you spend some time in the tomb bloodying it. Then come to me in my chambers in the academy.
Acolyte, I come with a message. Overseer Tremel can teach you the ways of the Sith, but not all of the skills. For that, there are specialists in the Academy. Overseer Tremel wishes you to meet them and learn what you can.
It's good to see such a young beauty of the true blood raised so high.
Something for you to aspire to. Your skin marks you as a worthy partner, but no Sith will dally below her rank. Keep that in your mind when the training grows difficult. You will find the best trainers in the Academy's archive. You are expected there shortly.
The Force is a weapon. I will show you how to wield it. Show no mercy. Acolyte, hold on a moment. Let me get a look at you. So you're Overseer Tremel's secret weapon. Impressive, to be sure. Afraid the old man waited too long to make his move, though. I'm Vemrin, and unlike you, I've fought and bled for everything I have. I demand respect.
This is a big place, Vemrin. There's more than enough room here for both of us.
I'm glad to hear you say that. There's plenty of room for you behind me. If Overseer Tremel had made his move a year ago when I first arrived, you might have had a chance. But now, too little, too late.
This is ridiculous, Vemrin. Let's just kill him and hide the body.
We're not on Balmora anymore, Torgus. There are rules, traditions. We'll leave the shortcuts to Overseer Tremel and his last pathetic hope here.
My honor is not to be questioned.
We'll see about that. Coming, Dolgus.
Be right there, Vemrin. Listen to me, you useless priss. Acolytes aren't allowed to murder each other. But accidents happen. It isn't murder without witnesses. No more warnings. Vemrin's the alpha monster here. You go after Vemrin, you die.
Good. You've returned. You seem to be in one piece. Tell me, how do you like your new blade?
I hope it's thirsty. I plan on drowning it.
What are you doing, Father? I only just got my warblade and I've been here 6 months.
I have my reasons, Escala. And you will not breathe a word of this to anyone. Do you hear?
Yes. Yes, Father.
Acolyte, this is Escala, my daughter. She's one of the advanced students here, on her way to becoming Sith, if she minds herself.
I'll keep quiet about your new charge, Father, but I won't be there if whatever you're planning blows up in your face.
Don't mind her. She's just sore that I'm keeping secrets. She growls, but she's loyal. Now, I thought I heard Vemrin's voice in the adjacent chamber before you arrived. Did he make his move so soon?
He just introduced himself to me.
If he didn't attack, he must not fully comprehend the threat you represent. Good, good. Still, I'd hoped we'd have more time. Vemrin's not the type to sniff around for too long before trying to take a bite. In a drive for sheer numbers, the criteria for Academy admittance has been relaxed. Now anyone with Force sensitivity is allowed entrance. Vemrin is mixed blood, the invisible rot eating at the foundation of the Empire. He must not be allowed to advance.
So, you're an elitist snob?
You say that like it's a bad thing. It's the Sith way. Only the best, only the most pure should be good enough. Unfortunately, Vemrin's caught the eye of Darth Barriss, one of the most influential Sith lords. He's being groomed to be Barriss's new apprentice. As Darth Barriss's apprentice, the power at Vemrin's fingertips will be considerable. He could change the Sith for the worse. You must proceed to your next trial immediately. I want you to interrogate 3 prisoners in the Academy jails and decide their fates. Consider each criminal's story carefully. The decisions you make will be scrutinized, so let your passions guide your judgments.
I will handle it.
Go to the Academy prison. Speak to Head Jailer Nash and return to me after you've passed judgment on the prisoners.
One more chirp from you, little bird, and you'll regret it.
Chirp, chirp, chirp. Ow, jerk. If you don't like that, just say so. I can do other animals too. Dire cat, frog dog, quaking monkey lizard, you name it.
You, I'm Jailer Nash. I run these cells and slave pits. You're the Acolyte Tremel sent for the test, right? He thinks highly of you.
That's good to hear. I want to do well.
You should know this situation is highly unusual. Normally an acolyte goes off well for the interrogation. Overseer Tremel, at these three shipped in for you. He thinks you're the next coming of Exar Kun. But you ought to know, Tremel ain't the only one paying attention to you. Now, these three prisoners have been transferred here for your inspection. You gotta interrogate them as needed, and then decide their fate. The convicted are usually executed, or given a trial by combat to see if they're worthy. Whatever you decide, you will be the one to carry out the sentence.
As it should be.
Ah, fine. Let's get started. This one on the left.
You freaks aren't getting anything new out of me! Just do whatever you're gonna do!
Let me make this plain as day. If you don't cooperate, I will kill you.
I'm not afraid to die.
Impudent to the last. As I was saying, she was sent to kill an Imperial spy in the Yavin system. Throughout her torture, she maintained that she was hired anonymously.
Get it through your damn head! I had no idea he was Imperial, and I don't know who hired me!
So you're telling me you're not a Republic assassin?
I'm not political. I work for whoever pays.
The point is, she doesn't deny the charge. So now you must decide. Execution or trial by combat. Which do you choose?
Neither, actually. She could prove useful. Send her to Imperial Intelligence.
I won't work for free.
Huh. You spared her. Interesting.
Please. I am a fellow Sith. Judge me with an open mind and grant me trial by combat, I beg you.
Your name, now.
This part of Waste is Davotek. Once a valued Sith champion, until he botched an important mission and caused 1,000 Imperial deaths. Now look at him.
I served faithfully for 24 years. Then one mistake, and they threw me away. Now I have been left here to rot. Please, let me feel the weight of a weapon once more.
I will grant your wish. A warrior should die with his boots on.
My thanks, young warrior.
This should be entertaining. Much of a fight, did he?
He died a warrior.
Ah, well, this last prisoner's a bit of a puzzle. He's called Breg, and he's a jittery little wretch, suspected of supplying forged documents to Republic agents. Strangely enough, he maintains his innocence, despite being severely tortured.
Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamna lebek.
Are you trying to tell me you've led a clean life?
Naki oya makmak. Nebaga imana, naki naya, bila magnam unya kamna lebek.
Ah, he's never wavered from that line. And the evidence is circumstantial. I suppose it's actually possible he didn't do it. So, what do you decide?
This matter is beneath me. Throw him back in his cell.
Karipaka yangnaya, harakam sergmera.
Well, I guess it's back to solitary for him. Well, that's that. You're an interesting one, kid. I can see why people are keeping tabs on you. Head back to Overseer Tremel. See what he thinks of your choices.
Is this everything?
Everything Lord Renning was able to obtain, yes.
Then run back to your master in the beast pens before I cut you in half. Sorry to make you wait, Acolyte. These interruptions are incredibly annoying. On to the business at hand, your test in the jails. First, the assassin, Solentz. She attempted to kill an Imperial spy, but was unaware of her client's affiliation. You assigned her to Imperial Intelligence. I commend you, that was excellent thinking. Never waste a potential resource.
Thank you, Overseer. I'm glad you approve.
What's more important is that Darth Barriss would approve. Now, Devatek, the failed warrior, why grant his wish for a trial by combat?
I did it out of respect for his service. He used to be a potent warrior.
We don't have time to honor yesterday's accomplishments. Devatek was an utter waste of space. Once something is no longer useful, it should be eradicated. Remember that. Now the forger who maintained his innocence, you refused to deal with him. Explain.
I ignore gnats and puddles of water. Must I explain that as well?
Yes. In fact, you do. Deciding not to engage is sloppy. You left the issue in limbo. Things fall through the cracks when they are disregarded. No matter how insignificant something seems, be definitive. You must always be thinking and considering every angle. Aside from a strong and skilled sword arm, that will be what impresses Darth Barriss the most. You're beginning to understand what it means to be Sith, but you're far from being able to impress Darth Barriss.
I'll try harder, Overseer. I promise.
If you don't, you're doomed. Remember that. Because I forced you into the Academy ahead of schedule, Darth Barriss will be predisposed to judging you severely. And by severely, I mean fatally. Now, we must hurry to your next trial. Every moment that passes, we risk discovery before we're ready. In the caverns of Mark Aragnos is the beast he left to guard his legacy. Go there, sit among the flames, and wait for the beast to come for you.
Sounds like a good opportunity for violence.
Hold nothing back. This creature is doom itself. Return to the Valley of the Dark Lords and find the tomb of Mark Aragnos. I'll see you when the beast is slain. Good luck.
Well, look who's here. Remember me?
You need to move out of my way.
I put myself in your way, buddy. On purpose. Notice anything interesting? No witnesses. No witnesses means no rules. No more shortcuts. No more special treatment. You're just gonna be another dead failure on Korriban. No, hold up. Look, I was wrong. What they're saying about you, totally true. So strong. I don't want to die.
Ask for no mercy and expect none. Die like a Sith.
I failed you, Vemrin.
We must speak quickly, Acolyte. There isn't much time. I may have made a slight miscalculation. The beast of Mark Aragnos was a great source of dark energy here on Korriban. When it was slain, there was a tremor in the Force.
Darth Barriss felt that tremor and has become aware of you. He demands an audience.
Tell me what to expect, Overseer.
Barriss is a serious man, but a master of deception. Everything he does and says is calculated.
He will attempt to trip you up, test your nature, get to the heart of who you are. Always take him seriously. And I mean always.
I can handle Darth Barriss.
Barriss is usually the one doing the handling.
We might not speak again, Acolyte. You're the best chance of stopping Vemrin. If you fail, I doubt there will be another strong enough. Good luck.
Meet Darth Barriss in his chambers, and hurry. He won't take kindly to waiting.
There, Tino. I believe that's the one.
Really? All right. Hey, you!
Careful, Tino.
Come on, I'm antsy for some action. You there? Are you the big shot they're all talking about? The one who's been personally summoned by Darth Barriss himself.
News sure does travel fast.
Please pardon my over-eager friend. It's just that we've heard so much about you.
And we want to get in good with you.
Tino? What my blunt partner here means is that if you need anything or anyone, say, dealt with, we'd like you to consider us.
She's talking about Vemrin. We'll kill him for you.
Sorry. I should have had Tino muzzled. So, what do you say? We know Vemrin tried to have you killed. Would you like him eliminated?
Something like this would have to be handled delicately.
Of course. We completely understand. There are rules. Acolytes are not to openly kill one another. Everyone knows of your rivalry. If you kill him, the Lords will presume your guilt.
But if Vemrin croaks while you get an alibi, people might be suspicious, but they won't be able to pin it on you. See?
I'm not interested. Sorry.
Let us prove ourselves to you. Spar with us, then decide if we have the skills to benefit you in this endeavor.
All right. Let's see what you've got.
At your best, boys. It's time to audition for the big show.
Oh.
You still took all four of us apart. This changes everything. From what I hear, Vemrin's every bit your physical equal. If we can't even hold up sparring against you, we'll never be able to kill him.
You've got it all wrong. Vemrin is just a lot of big talk and reputation.
Really? You mean he gets by on the illusion of strength?
What does this mean, Fine?
It means Vemrin is a dead man, and we're going to have the most potent of allies.
Most of you will not return from this endeavor. If you die, you will be forgotten. If you give up, you will be killed. No, out of my sight.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
You should. This is the end of the line for you, Clemeral. Just make sure you stay out of my way.
Look here, Vemrin. I see the upstart, but no sign of Douglas.
Clemeral, Vemrin, you have been dismissed.
Yes, Master.
I underestimated you by sending Dolgus. It will not happen again.
Are you having trouble with Acolyte Vemran, supplicant?
If he insists on getting in my face like that, he's gonna have trouble with me.
He has been hardened into a lethal machine. Vemran has paid his dues. He's fought a deck stacked against him to get here. You, on the other hand. Let me get a closer look at you. Yes, as I suspected. Overseer Tremel has done you and this academy a great disservice. Your warblade came early. Prisoners flown in for your convenience. Even a beast here on Korriban instead of off-world in the wild. The pacing of the trials is deliberate. Only full immersion over time produces results. Your mind is soft, unhoned, undisciplined.
It was never my intention to offend.
But it is offensive to be presented with an acolyte who doesn't even have a rudimentary understanding of what it means to be Sith. The first month of trials should be dedicated to philosophy, conceptual tactics, understanding of the Sith Code. Recite the Sith Code for me, acolyte, and explain its meaning in battle, war, and politics.
I don't recall learning a Sith Code, my lord.
Your ability is undeniable. But your readiness and your understanding of the Sith way is woefully lacking. I am your master now. Tremel was becoming lax before you ever arrived. His unwillingness to adapt to the evolving Sith paradigm has become a liability. These are the actions of a traitor. Traitors are executed. I grant you immunity from punishment. Kill Tremel. And bring back his hand as proof.
I do not like the idea of killing him, but I'll do it if I must.
I do not make requests, supplicant. Now, leave. I'm sure Tremel is still in his chambers. Don't return until you've killed him.
I didn't expect to see you again so soon. Has Barriss sent you back to me?
I'm here to kill you.
Then I have been outplayed. Barriss has the authority, but I did not think he would do something this overt. Either I die, or he forces me to kill you, and to destroy my own plan. A masterstroke. Very well, you have your orders, acolyte. Know that it gives me no pleasure to kill you.
Let's get this out of the way.
I'll try to make your end quick and painless. It's the least I can do. Amazed. I knew you were strong in the Force, but not like this. You're more than ready to challenge Vemran. Barriss won't be able to deny that now. He'll have the satisfaction of my death. But I die knowing my success. Go ahead. End this.
You fought bravely, Overseer. Die with your head held high.
Farewell, acolyte. The purity of the Sith lies with you.
What's this? The acolyte returns, and with a bloodied weapon. I assume this means Tremel is no more. Give me his hand. Here, take this one ring as a memento. Remembering the past can strengthen resolve and embolden the spirit. I am impressed you had the fortitude to destroy him. You know he thought of you as family. How did it feel to betray him?
I did what was called for.
You mask your feelings well, as long as you don't suppress them. You have taken your first step to understanding the Sith Code. Peace is a lie. There is only passion. Through passion, we gain strength. Through strength, we gain power. Through power, we gain victory, and through victory, our chains are broken. The Force shall set us free. By embracing the code and destroying Tremel, you have freed yourself from his shackles and escaped his fate.
You've made your point. I understand.
That's more like it. I had a feeling you'd be a fast learner. Now, there are sacred ruins in the tomb of Tulak Horde. The ancient inscriptions that once adorned the walls of each ruin lie in pieces. You will venture through the entire tomb, search all of the ruins, and bring me a shard from each of these inscriptions. You will do this, or you will die. Vemran and my other acolytes have already been sent. There are no rules regarding how they secure the shards, and they will stop at nothing. Fight your way through the tomb of Tulak Horde in the Valley of the Dark Lords, and bring me the shards from each of the ruined shrines.
You did it, didn't you? You got the shards from the tomb, and you're on your way back to Lord Barriss.
Are you here to congratulate me?
I'll take that as a yes. Stop! I'm sorry. I made a mistake. I tried to get through the tomb, but there were just too many Shyrak. I barely escaped. I figured better to ambush you and take your shards. But I see that's just as futile. Vemran is already inside with Barriss. All the other acolytes died. You were my only chance. Now, I'm doomed. I'll never become Sith. Unless I return with the shards, Barriss will have me killed.
I'll save Barriss the trouble of listening to your whimpering. Die!
The prodigal supplicant returns. And with all the shards from the tomb of Tulak Horde. Superb. It seems your hopes have been dashed, Vemran.
Appearances can be deceptive.
Excuse Vemran, supplicant. He didn't take kindly to you, turning those young acolytes on him, even though they were only untrained novices.
He should thank me. Novices or not, I bet he had his hands full.
The tension is thick between you two. A great source of emotion to feed on. I wonder what will happen when it boils over. You both stand on the precipice of becoming Sith. But only one of you will have the opportunity to claim a special lightsaber and serve as my apprentice. I thought it would be you, Vemran, but I've changed my mind.
What? I've done everything you've asked. Better than any of the others. The honor should be mine.
Ignore Vemrin, Lord Barriss. His world is crumbling around him.
Today, Vemrin is every bit your equal. But the Force is stronger with you, Acolyte. And there is a power sleeping within you. It was a simple decision. Now, Vemrin, go wait in my antechamber for your instructions. This instant! Now, I hope you fathom how fortunate you are to be singled out. If you become my apprentice, the galaxy will bend before you.
You're not going to regret this, Barriss. I was born to be Sith.
The lightsaber you will seek is old and powerful. It is housed in a forbidden cavern in the tomb of Nargasado, where few Sith have ever set foot. Almost no one knows how to find the secret entrance. But there is a Twi'lek in the holding pens who was caught breaking in there. I hear she is quite willful. Take her and make her show you the entrance to the forbidden cave.
I will take care of that.
Other acolytes seeking to complete their trials are sent to the tomb, where Academy laws are waived. They will try to murder you. This test will determine if you become Sith. So bolster yourself. To set foot in the tomb of Nargasadao is to breathe in death itself.
Ouch! Give it a rest, will ya?
I'm getting my fill of fun while I still can, slave. As if on cue, look who's back. Word is you might become Lord Barriss's apprentice. Nice work if you can get it. So, I hear you'll be relieving me of this Twi'lek. She's a pain in the neck.
Ha! Who's a pain in the neck? I'm the one wearing a shock collar.
Consider that a going away present, Twi'lek. Seems you might be useful for something after all. This bruiser is taking you into the tomb where we caught you.
None of you can figure out how to activate the tomb statues to open the forbidden cavern, huh? You got some kind of business in that secret Sith chamber, do you?
Yes, and I'd appreciate your help.
Don't bother being pleasant. Here, kid, take the shock control color. I'll set it to a high level. Use it enough, she'll show you the back door to her mother's house.
I suppose I can play tomb tour guide. A lot of work went into cracking that nut, but I did it once. I can do it again. So we're clear. I'm officially on strike when it comes to domestic duties.
You'll do everything I require, and I mean everything.
Don't get any twisted ideas in that Sithy head of yours. Lead the way. I'll show you the unlocking points throughout the tomb, and then open the secret door for you. This is it. The secret entrance to the hidden cavern is in here. Just let me get my bearings.
Take your time, slave. Just have the entrance uncovered by the time I finish killing your new master.
Can't say I'm surprised to see you, Vemrin. You're remarkably predictable.
My passions run deeper than yours. I am the true essence of what it is to be Sith. My legacy has suffered long enough. After today, you will be forgotten. It ends here and now.
Barriss's apprentice was my destiny. Did I come this far and overcome such adversity, only to be proven unworthy?
I have waited a long time to put you in your place. Consider this. Killing you was easy.
Then do it. Finish me.
Wow. Nice work.
Glad to impress you.
The secret entrance is right here.
Been most helpful.
It's nice to be acknowledged. Thanks.
Yeah.
My father was a staunch traditionalist, and he was especially hard on me. But he's my blood. Did you think you could kill him and get away with it?
Who told you I killed your father?
Everybody says so. The whole place knows you killed him. And now you have to die.
Well, I suppose the whole place can't be wrong.
You'll rue the day you took his life. Attack!
I am beside myself. Not only did you get the Twi'lek to cooperate, but you completed the task and claimed the ancient lightsaber. Venran was not in my chamber as I instructed. I take it he sought to stop you and claim the ancient weapon as his own.
He tried and failed. Venran was nothing if not consistent.
Bravo! I see you may indeed become one of the strongest Sith in the galaxy. Your trials are over. You are now my apprentice.
I am your humble servant, Master. I bow before you.
Rise, my apprentice. This is only the beginning. With you at my right hand, we shall strike fear into the Empire's enemies. I must convene with the Emperor and inform him of your progress. This shuttle pass will take you to Dromund Kos. Meet me at the Citadel there.
As you decree, my lord.
Take the Twi'lek slave as my gift. Do with her as you wish. If she'll be of use, by all means take her with you to Dromund Kos.
There you are. You've attracted more than Darth Barriss's attention, young one. I'm Lord Lokar. I'm called upon to promote a specially promising Sith, and you have been deemed worthy of my guidance. I will expose you to what Darth Barriss will not.
What kind of guidance do you provide?
You will choose between two disciplines. One follows the path of Marco Ragnos, who focused the dark side to become nearly unwoundable in battle. The other one was mastered by Naga Sadao, who could intuit where his foe was weakest and then strike precisely with devastating effect. I hand you over to Lord Krimin. Tell him the path you choose, and he will complete this phase of your training.
You have my thanks.
I hope someday you eclipse your master. Good luck to you.
Bagthra wanawaga mi bunawa duetwipe. Chechopa kuma ni umpi put malia bedwana ni bobo. Umpa hupa, chikilia umpasa do biska. Pampawula ji ota kakoga huta nupisto. Bagthra Wanawaga mi Bunawa Duetwipe. Che chopa kuma ni umpi but malia bedwana ni bobo. Umpa hupa, jikilia umpasa do biska. Pampa wula ji ota kakoga huta nupisto.